Jean-Michel Basquiat was an explosive force on the streets. Unfortunately for the art world, he died way too soon. Jean-Michel Basquiat was born in 1960. He lived in Park Slope, Brooklyn, with his father Gerard from Haiti and his mother Mathilde from a Puerto Rican family. As a young boy, Basquiat loved to draw. Often, he used paper that his father brought home from his accounting firm to draw things inspired by cartoons. His mother often took young Basquiat to museums to look at art. Basquiat attended kindergarten a year early. In 1968, Basquiat was hit by a car and was hospitalized for 1 month. He got a copy of Gray's Anatomy, which would later inspire him to start a band called Gray. Due to a promotion, he moved with his dad and two sisters to Puerto Rico. Jean-Michel often ran away from home. Once, he stayed at a local radio station. The employees called his father, who immediately drove him home. In 1976, the Basquiats moved back to New York City, where Basquiat met Al Diaz, who was an early collaborator on Basquiat's graffiti. Basquiat created SAMO to stand for Same Old. SAMO was the name Basquiat used to tag his graffiti. In 1977, SAMO began popping up everywhere around New York with philosophical sayings by it. In June of 1978, Jean-Michel Basquiat left home for good. His dad gave him some money with the faith and understanding that he would try his best to succeed. Basquiat began to make postcards and hand-painted t-shirts to make a little bit of money. Basquiat then sold a postcard to Andy Warhol in a Soho restaurant. Basquiat quickly became friends with Keith Haring and Andy Warhol.
They started showing together in the early 80s, and Warhol really admired Basquiat. And in many ways, we can see Basquiat, a generation younger than Warhol, kind of carrying on the tradition of pop art, right? Pop art was a movement of art making that came about after World War II, and where artists were suddenly looking to popular culture and signs and advertising and pulling them into the work of art. And we might say that it's clear what Warhol saw in Basquiat was an artist that was continuing the legacy of the pop artist. Hi, I'm Michelle White, and I'm a senior curator at the Manil Collection in Houston. I mean, I think he made a tremendous impact that artists today are still looking at what he did. I think what was so important about Basquiat is that, you know, he started as a graffiti artist, and for the first time, we had an artist that was using the language of the street and the art of graffiti and bringing it into the work of art. And that was pretty radical at the time and something that had never been done before.
Andy Bell is the guitarist for British rock band Ride. Bell went to Basquiat's art exhibit called Boom for Real. He and bass guitarist Steve Quirlt got really excited and loved his vibe. Basquiat learned a secret hobo language and incorporated it in his graffiti. 3 slashes means this is not a safe place. Once the guitarists learned that, they came up with a new album title, This Is Not a Safe Place. In many of Basquiat's art pieces, he incorporated little messages in them. Basquiat used his creativity in art along with symbols and important African-American artists, athletes, and others who rose in the face of adversity to break racial barriers.
I think he was a part of a group of artists beginning 81, 82, that were called the neo-expressionists. Sometimes people use that term to describe this moment in art history. But prior to this time, painting was primarily abstract, and that was the dominant way of making. And this was the legacy of artists like Jackson Pollock or Willem de Kooning or Lee Krasner. So the 1980s saw this sort of radical shift of artists suddenly turning back to the figure and bringing in everyday life, and not just everyday life like pop artists were doing. I always feel like a great Basquiat painting makes you think. Like, it almost looks like a puzzle or a code, right? Where you're trying to sort of sort out these crazy scrawled letters and trying to figure out what they say and what they mean. Something he does in a really interesting way is he draws the same or paints the same images over and over. It's almost like he's developing his own language or vocabulary with these shapes or drawings. And one of those motifs that he's constantly returning to, and you can see it throughout his work, is the use of the crown. Because like many artists, Basquiat is taking signs and symbols and thinking about the many ways one symbol, like a simple crown, can mean so many things. It can mean something about tradition, it can mean monarchy, it can mean something right really different when you're pairing a crown that's related to a sort of European aristocracy and attach it to a depiction of an African-American man. And that's what he wanted to do with his play with images and words. And there's other motifs that he uses that you can also find. It's almost like a puzzle where if you go through, see how many you can find. And it's a pretty interesting challenge.
In August of 1988, Basquiat dies of mixed drug intoxication, cocaine and opioids. About 300 of Basquiat's friends and family members attend his memorial gathering at St. Peter's Church on Lexington Avenue and 54th Street of New York City. What was left of Gray and others played music, and poetry was read. Everyone remembers Basquiat, and Keith Haring made a piece of art called Pile of Crowns for him. He inspired artists like Jay-Z, Kanye West, Rick Ross, Nas, J. Cole, Lil Wayne, and Damian Marley. As Basquiat once said, black people were never really portrayed in art, but he, Basquiat, the little kid who ran away from home, Sammo, was the one who really sealed the deal for black people in art.